Cesium sensorial.
Did two men with a trunk get off here by any chance?
Oui.
Which way did they go?
That way, monsieur.
Oh, where are we anyway?
Guise. France. Let me help you, monsieur. There is a taxi up front and a hotel nearby in Rennes-le-Château.
Appreciate it.
All right, so we're on day two, 5 p.m. to 10 p.m., where we are now Grace. And the game only has a total of 3 days. The third day, everything goes down. And as you can see here, Grace will pick up a glass, which, as far as I know, you can use to listen at the door. If you try to fingerprint it, it'll say there's no fingerprints. So you can listen at the doors, but Grace... Unless I missed it, I tried all the doors. Grace doesn't really hear anything. There's either no one there, or the fact that you'll just hear someone perhaps taking a shower or snoring. So I am not sure what the glass is for Grace, because as far as I know, she doesn't use it for anything else. So if you know what the glass is for, or if I missed somewhere where Grace was supposed to use that glass to listen to someone, feel free to let me know in the comments. In the meantime, Grace is going to be over here, and she's going to ask the young woman behind the counter at the hotel some information about the treasure, the Templars, the Scions, you know, and like, is she interested in the treasure? And she'll say stuff like, oh, you know, I've heard about it, but, you know, I've never really done anything about it. So now, since the time has changed, we're going to see what has changed around here. And from here, Gabe and Mosley, they're talking about Grace, essentially, and as well as the tour guide woman who just showed up. And Mosley will make a comment and go, ooh, yeah, no, she's really into you. And Gabe says, oh, it's just pheromones. It's what I give off. And so Gabe will kind of say that, you know, with Grace here, there's not much he can do in terms of the tour guide woman, because, you know, she's kind of like a ball and chain. She's in his room, so it's not like he can take her back to her room, because Grace would be there and stuff like that. So Grace gets kind of upset about it, and rightfully so, because these two clearly have some chemistry between each other. But it never really fully gets explored. And this young man here, who we can't seem to get any fingerprints of, more on that later, he and Grace get pretty close throughout this. He's very, very helpful, unknowing to Grace until she starts piecing it together, that he is the one who is providing some extra information to Grace to help her make things happen. So, I'm going to go over here, take a look, see if there's anything. So the window's closed, can't open it, he's not home, doesn't want to do anything. It is somewhere between 5 and 10 p.m., so it's not shocking that he would not want to be in his house. But if you go around to the side, you can talk to him, and you can ask him a few questions, such as the treasure, the scion, and stuff like that. But you can see it's pretty cool that they consider that, and they closed his drape as well from the inside. So. We've already got the pamphlet, so we're going to mosey on, but we can look at it. And once again, you can see I zoomed in, but in the future ones, they'll be at the normal resolution, so they'll be smaller. But when I initially looked at it, I wanted to zoom in so you can actually read it, because you're going to get something known as Le Serpent Rouge, and that pamphlet is going to come in real handy in terms of how to resolve things. So I gave it a quick read just to see if he would have anything else to discuss. And if you look on that door, it sure looks like there is something there, and it's closed. But then Grace goes right back down. But, you know, let's take a look at that envelope. And it's a copy of Le Serpent Rouge, which is what I was just talking about. So someone is clearly leaving Grace little hints. And it is, I believe his name is pronounced Buccelli. Or no, sorry. Wait, I totally can't remember his name now. Anyway, it's the guy who we can't get any fingerprints off of. It's him. And his secret will be revealed. Try to get fingerprints. And there is one. It's interesting that Gabe and Mosley are inside talking, that we just saw, and yet Gabe's motorcycle that he rented is missing. Because there he is, he's right there. So it's curious why his motorcycle would be missing. Could be that the guy who owns it uses it for his own personal one, so that could be. And here we go, adding data into Sydney. And that is the drawing from the robes from the winery. That's the note. That what's his name was scribbling on the ground. Emilio, there we go. Buccelli is the baldish dude, the priestly guy, I believe, if I remember correctly. Now the thing that's weird is what you can and cannot scan into Sydney. So for example, you can scan in a cassette tape that you record. Not sure how. But you can't scan in some papers of La Serpent Rouge for Sydney, but you can scan a fingerprint. So it's kind of weird. So we're going to do some more translating to find out what some is. And this is where it gets crazy. So Sydney will diagnose these things and say, hey, there's some geometry shapes I'm seeing in these messages, as well as some letters, and then you can try to translate it. And then when you translate it to French, it'll say, ah, then give you some information. And it'll also tell you that it can see some things. And so, and I don't know how it sees that symbol in there, but whatever. So you can keep translating this stuff. And where there is a symbol, it'll tell you. And these symbols will be able to be used by Sydney, which is weird. Like, if I haven't found a square, I can't just draw a square in Sydney. And when you analyze it, it'll find other symbols. It talks about the rotation. So this is where it gets haywire. And for the sake of my own sanity of having to relive this, I may speed through this and not comment, because it drove me crazy trying to figure this part out. It was a lot of stabbing and just hoping for the best. Like, for example, one of the things I noticed when I was, see, like, I'm just clicking on the grid, draw, like, no, that's not it. So I wasn't even sure how to move this map around. So you have the left and the right, and I was trying to drag the left side. That's not how you do it. Click on the right side, and that's where it'll zoom in on. And you can see I'm drawing points on the map, and things are going crazy. And you can tell this is a different save game, because now you can see the frame of the computer. And this one, I think this was 1024 by 768 to see if it would work better, because I was having issues with the map. And see, I could see that cross, so I was starting to think, okay, maybe that cross is the key, and I just need to find all these crosses in these different cities to see if I can make a triangle or a pentagram or something. Because you see those shapes in those messages. This took a ridiculous amount of effort. So you can see I got two of them right, but that third church up to the north doesn't count right now, but at least I got two right so far. So the struggle is real without using a walkthrough. So now I'm just trying to draw essentially a triangle to see if that's it, because you have that top and then the two at the bottom. But yeah, you know what, for the sake of everyone's sanity and me just talking about this, I'll go ahead and just fast forward this portion of it. And let's hang tight as we just bypass the insanity that is Sydney. If you watch the regular playthrough, you can watch it all. Here's where I'm just trying to draw a pentagram or something, or make these things match. Like, do they have to be inside the circle? How's that? All right, I'm just gonna start fast forwarding now. Alright, so now we're back as Gray. So we've got a circle. Took a lot of effort just to get a circle and figure out what to do with that circle. And since something has happened, we figured out the circle. We go downstairs. There's Gabe, Mosley, and the tour guide. And they're going to go out for drinks or whatever and have some fun. And Gabe actually makes a comment that, no, Grace wouldn't want to go. You know, she's too busy doing research. And Grace overhears that she would probably like to go and not be stuck doing research. So we're going to go over here, see if they have anything to say first. All And I like that she keeps forgetting Grace's name. All right, so once again, we're going to try to decipher this code. Blue apples is a code word if you search in Sydney for grapes. I already know that because I've already done that search, but there is that symbol with the circle that is in the square that we saw in one of the messages. So that is what I'm trying to recreate here. And it's a nightmare. I'm just spinning in circles, literally, or spinning a square in a circle, spinning a square outside of a circle. Anyway, let's just go ahead and fast forward this part too. So all of that because I missed part of the meridian, which is part of that puzzle thing where it says it'll be on the horizon of the meridian, whatever. So you actually have to have it and then it locks in place. And I saved that game because I hate this part of the game, seriously. All right, anyway. So back to it being interesting, we're back to being Grace. Figured out another thing, and now something else has happened. Now they're talking, and they want to pay, I believe it's Bridge, and they need some more players, and once again, she invites what's-her-name and then says Grace to play. And so once again, now that they've all had a drink, you can use the thing. And they'll say, I already have his, but that one guy, Emilio, we still never got his fingerprint, and still, yet again, no fingerprint for Emilio. Why? Why? All right. So they're over here enjoying a good game of bridge. And Grace is going to go out and do some exploring. So now that we have figured out part of the riddle and read some more, we now have more questions to ask him about the sunrise, which we just found on the map, or sunset. I think it's sunset. It's either sunset or sunrise. See, literally, I just beat this game. It's probably been like three or four. No, it's been like, well, shoot, I think it's probably been almost a week now since I beat the game, and I've already forgotten what all the clues are. Now, see, this thing, I know you're supposed to do something with it, because it talks, she even says when you click on it, oh, this is the angels from part of the riddle thing. And so I know you're supposed to do something with the hand gestures, and I could not figure out what it is. So as Grace begins to look at Le Serpent Rouge, it'll highlight the parts that she has to figure out first. But I zoomed in so you can read everything really close for the first time. And as you click it, Grace will actually read the lines. So if you're wondering why there is a pause, that is why. If you watch the playthrough, she's actually reading each of the lines. And so what I always try to do is, I did it in Gabriel Knight 2, Gabriel Knight 1, I want to get the most out of the game. If there's something where the character will read it, I want to click it and just listen to it to get the most experience out of the game. Stuff that they've clearly programmed in, intended to be heard or seen. I still haven't looked at the walkthrough for Gabriel Knight 3 to see what I might have missed, because there is a pretty huge gap in terms of points that I'm missing. So I should look at that sometime. I will say one thing that is pretty cool that Grace has done all this research, and in day 3 at the end of the game, Gabe is separated from her, but he's able to basically radio her in for help on what he's facing. And I think it's pretty cool that stuff from that pamphlet and the Super Rouge and stuff like that are part of what Grace can help you with. Now, I'm surprised no one is bothered by the fact that there is a spirit just holding up a glass of wine. I'm joking, it's a bug, and it happens a few times in my playthrough where I walk out and the glass is simply floating in the middle of the air. Alright, here we go with more Sydney. So now, with the chess thing, it talks about, you know, the 8x8 or whatever. Good old Wilkes shows up and says, hey, I can show you what I found in terms of the treasure if you just go out on a date with me, since the tour guide has left with Gabe. And so Wilkes is drunk and tries to basically get fresh with Grace, but she keeps slapping him away but pretending to be innocent at the same time, and she's asking him about what his thumper has found. And when she says something about the treasure, he says the treasure's right here, and takes her hand and grabs it and thrusts it towards her crotch, or towards his crotch. To which Grace rightfully flips him on his ass. I will say that Gabriel Knight 3, since I just said ASS, Gabriel Knight 3 probably is not for children, A, because it does have a lot of, it's a pretty thick story, but on top of that, Gabe and Mosley, and I think everyone, pretty much swears at some point. Just trying to see if there's anything I can get. See what has changed around here. I love the lighting on that church, the way they did that. And the church is closed. Sealed shut tight now. As you would expect, everything between 5 and 10 is currently closed, except for the tower. You can just go right on up. I try to use a binoculars up there. He pretty much says, well, it's nighttime. I can't really see anything. So just looking around, we can see that there are no motorcycles in the area, so probably no one around. But regardless, just checking anyway, Because last time, Mosley somehow got up here without a motorcycle. So just driving around, looking around, no motorcycle. Let's get out of here. Just trying to see where to go next. No motorcycle. All right. And no motorcycle. All right, let's go. Oh, a moped. Someone is here. So let's go see what's going on. Well, 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 if it isn't our buddy Mosley. So I love that Gabe just sneaks up on him. And you find out that Mosley and the tour instructor woman, they've actually kind of teamed up in regards to locating this treasure. So we know Mosley's into the treasure or something along the lines. So we can spy on him. And that's right. I should go back and talk about how the alarm was set for 2 a.m. because we saw his alarm was set. So we asked the hotel to do a 2 a.m. wake-up call. So we know that he's doing something at 2 a.m. and it looks like he's burying something. And this time Gabe is pretty brave and not moving. We can kind of see where he is doing it. And so this is so funny. I basically leave to go get my shovel. Walk all the way back, and when I get there it tells me that I can't use it, like there's no way to grab it, so it's in the inventory automatically, which I should have paid attention to and not assume that it's just on the bike. So I gotta walk all the way back, find that hole and dig away. And it's funny because he says, let me go get my shovel, and walks off screen and walks right back. And so when you look, it's basically what appears to be the lineage of Jesus. And there's a fingerprint there, which we can probably guess is his. Just checking to see if finding it does anything with him, but it does not. He's nowhere to be seen. So we're just going to go ahead and leave the area. Then we see a car go by. But it went by too fast, but it looks like it did leave some tracks. They sure look familiar. So we can confirm that probably the people who killed the two guards are also people who hang out at that winery. So Gabe will be headed back that way shortly as a reporter once again. But when he goes home, he checks in. Then he has a dream of these three weird-looking guys who zap the unicorn, slit its throat, and drink its blood. Now, it seems offbeat, this whole unicorn thing and the guy growing a horn and drinking the blood, but you'll find out why. There's this where it looks like a vampire has floated into the room, and oof, wow, cut Grace's shirt open. By the time Gabe is actually able to stand, the window's closed, and she's still lying there. Shirt still closed, laying on her side. And Gabe lays next to her, concerned about her, takes his amulet, and you can assume what happens next.